A calendar spread option, also known as a time spread or horizontal spread, is an options trading strategy that involves buying and selling options of the same underlying asset with the same strike price, but with different expiration dates. Calendar spreads profit from the relative difference in time decay rates between the two options. The goal is for the short leg to lose value faster than the long leg, leading to a net profit for the overall position. This strategy can be implemented using either call options or put options. So how does a calendar spread work? To create a calendar spread, you choose an options contract with a particular strike price and sell it while simultaneously buying an options contract with the same strike price but at a later expiration date. The key to a calendar spread is the difference in expiration dates between the two options. The option with the longer expiration date is known as the long leg, and the option with the shorter expiration date is known as the short leg. When setting up the calendar spread, the long leg typically costs more than the short leg due to the extra time value. The spread's total cost represents the maximum potential loss, while the potential profit is the difference in value between the two legs after the first one expires. Calendar spreads are typically used in neutral market conditions when the underlying asset is expected to remain relatively stable in the short term. It's essential for the underlying asset's price not to experience significant movements during the life of the spread. Since the goal of a calendar spread is to profit from time and lack of volatility, the strike price should be as near as possible to the current stock price. Let's take a look at an example calendar spread, starting with the opening. I'm going to use JP Morgan as the underlying stock symbol JPM, and it has a current stock price of $156.95. So here I'm going to set my legs. My short leg, I'm going to set with an expiration date 2 weeks out with a strike price of $157.50. And then my long leg, I'm going to set out another 2 weeks at the same strike price, $157.50. These are both calls. And as you can see, the one that I'm selling here is going to be around $217 to $222 per share for a contract of 100 shares. And the one that I'm buying is going to be somewhere between $305 and $315 per share for 100 shares of a contract. So in total, this position will probably open with a debit of around 91 cents per share. So total debit for this will be right around $92. So to review, I'm selling an August 11th call at a price of right around $2.20. And I'm also buying an 8/25 call for right around $3.10 a share. So my total cost to open this position is going to be right around $92. Now, as long as the stock price remains below right around $157 at the time of the short option expiration, the short option will expire worthless. I'll now be left with the long option. Theta, or the effect of time decay on an option price, increases as the expiration date approaches. If I open this position and then 2 weeks later the short position expires, I now have additional 2 weeks before the long position expires. As long as the stock price hasn't dropped, it's reasonable to assume it might still have around 2/3 of its original value left. And looking at the short position price today, it might be reasonable to assume that in 2 weeks, my long position will be worth right around $2.20, or a total value of $220. So if I now turn around and sell that long position after the short position is expired, I'll be collecting $220 compared to my original cost to open this position of $92. So a little over $100 profit on this position if the stock price remains below $165.50 at expiration. What if the stock price rises before the short position expires? Both options will increase in intrinsic value, but the short position will lose all of its extrinsic value. Its value at expiration is simply the difference between the original $157.50 strike price and the actual stock price. So if the stock price rises a dollar to $158.50, the option will be worth $1 or times 100 for the contract size for $100. But the long option will have also increased in intrinsic value, offsetting that. This strategy can handle a little upward or downward movement. Now, what if the stock price falls significantly before expiration? The short position will expire worthless, but the long position will also decrease significantly in value. The further the stock price falls, the less of the original value you will retain in your long position. Theoretically, this loss could increase to a maximum of the original debit, or $92. If there aren't any major events before the first option expires, the likelihood of a significant decline is pretty low. What's more likely is that the stock will move up or down a little bit, giving you somewhere between zero and your max profit potential. This is why it's important to choose a stable stock. Stocks with a high volatility don't have as high likelihood of profitability with this strategy. So when should you use a calendar spread option? Calendar spreads are used when you expect minimal movement in the underlying asset's price, but anticipate that time decay will affect the shorter-term option more significantly. If you believe that the implied volatility levels of the stock will decrease over time, a calendar spread can take advantage of this expectation. Calendar spreads can also be employed as a hedging strategy for an existing options position, providing limited risk while allowing for potential additional gains if the underlying asset remains stable. When should you not use a calendar spread? A calendar spread is most profitable when the underlying asset does not make any significant moves in either direction until after the short option expires. Be careful of things like earnings releases, Fed interest rate decisions, or any other external events that could cause significant price movement prior to the expiration of the short position. Similar to vertical spreads, calendar spreads offer limited risk compared to some other options strategies, but they also come with limited profit potential as well. As with any option strategy, make sure you have a solid understanding of the risks involved before implementing a calendar spread. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please hit that like button. Also, make sure you subscribe to see more great videos just like this. And if you have any questions, post them in the comments, and I will be sure to answer them for you. Thanks for watching.